do they want to kill you?
They want my DNA to build more of me.
Might makes me right.
Now that's what I call a fight.
Yeah.
The road is long. I wish you well.
Thank you. The Dermond Priory is a bastion of history, containing the collected wisdom of the ages. For 200 years, we've stood upon a foundation of lore, research, and exploration. When Lion's Arch was flooded by the rise of the Nation of Ore, our forebearers rescued the city's survivors. We salvaged knowledge that would otherwise have been lost. Now, as the dragons ravage ever greater expanses of Tyria, we must do even more. We must discover the truths that Tyria needs to survive. Where the dragons came from, why, and how to end their threat. The Priory is dedicated to learning. Siren, one of our most cunning scholars, will provide tutelage to help you gain wisdom that you will need. Dermond, our founder, said it best. Your power is only equal to the sum of your knowledge. If that's true, then we're Tyria's best hope to survive the darkness gathering on the horizon. Welcome to the Dermond Priory.
I'm a Magister of the Order, but we don't need to use titles. Just call me Siren.
Happy to meet you. I'm looking forward to working with the Dermond Priory.
It's nice to see that you're enthusiastic. I know I'm supposed to take you straight back to the Priory, but I'd like to take a little side trip. While I was waiting for you, Explorer Kecht was telling me this really interesting story about an old dwarven tomb. And guess what? It's right on our way! I'll still take you to meet Steward Gix at the main Priory building, but I want to have a bit of fun first.
Magister Siren, you're not listening to me! We don't even know if the story is true! What if this tomb doesn't even exist? What if it's just a legend?
Oh, Kecht, stop being a spoilsport. If I ignore this, those skulky dredge might find the tomb first. And how would that turn out? They'd destroy it! Come on. It won't hurt anything to go look around a bit. The novice doesn't mind, right?
Exploring an ancient tomb on my first day in the Order? Sounds fun. I don't mind at all.
Then it's settled. I'll meet you at Moland's Summit, novice. Don't keep me waiting, okay?
Look alive, you lot. Let's make some coin.
You'll find everything you need here.
Go.
Might makes me right.
Look at these glorious snow-dusted mountains. I love the Shiver Peaks. They're so magnificent. Can you believe the ancient dwarves thought this was a good place for a tomb? It feels so alive. Such a strange choice.
It's beautiful, but I'll admit I don't know much about dwarves. What's so interesting about this tomb?
The dwarves are almost extinct, but in their time they knew a lot about the dragons. The Priory studies dwarven tombs to learn as much as we can. This tomb's completely unexplored. If there hadn't been a little earthquake, it would have stayed buried beneath rocks and ice. Kecht's old scroll said this was the tomb of a dwarven prince. It might have... Uh-oh. Look at those dig marks. Dredge. Shoots and thorns. I knew the dredge would find this place. That's why I wanted to come right away. See, the dredge were once enslaved by dwarves. They'll destroy anything dwarven. Once this cave opened up, they probably flocked here like jackdaws to a bone.
Then we'd better hurry. Hey, do you hear that? Siren, watch out!
These dredge are good at getting underfoot.
Interesting.
writing on this is certainly dwarven. Keep searching. Maybe we can find more. Think we can find anything else?
When I see you back at the Priory, I'll buy you an ale.
That was interesting.
Who are you? What are you doing here? Dwarf sympathizers, I'll bet.
We want to know the importance of this tomb. What can you tell us?
Absolutely nothing. Come, let's show them the meaning of buried and forgotten.
Not much of a conversation, Mr. Z.
That talking tree's gone crazy. Get it off me. I'll tell you anything. Just let me go.
This talking tree will tear your limbs off, buddy. Is this all you found in the tomb, or did your people destroy some of the relics?
Those relics are nothing compared to... We tried to shatter it, but we couldn't. It was too powerful. Nothing could harm it.
Destroy what? Another relic? One like these?
Junk! No. It was a sword. We sent it to the southern ruins, hoping to find some way to destroy it. Death to the dwarves!
A sword? Maybe the writing on these relics will tell us more. I bet Gix can translate it. Let's head back to the Priory and ask him. Talking tree? That's the best he had. I'm more insulted by his lack of imagination.
Shadows embrace you.
on. We need to show Gix these artifacts.
Ah, Magister Siren. You've taken your time getting here. Come, introduce me to our new friend. Magister Siren, yet again you neglect your duty to go on an adventure. You're completely out of control, you blasted weed. You're very lucky my expedition team needed your help to get out of there. I'm going to go easy on you. This time. Ah, our newcomer. I'm sorry for all the trouble. Siren is something of a firecracker. Don't wheedle me, you leaf-addled reprobate! Why, I tolerate him... Oh, my goodness. This is fascinating. Tell me, was anything missing from the cave?
Yes! The dredge had taken a weapon from the cave. That's a wonderful guess. Guess something else, Gix. This is fun.
By the cogs of creation, they took the sanguinary blade. It's a legendary sword made of frozen blood. The weapon was lost when the stone summit dwarves vanished.
A sword made of blood? What kind of blood could possibly be made into a weapon?
We're on it, sir. You can count on us.
These artifacts are amazing. The prince's name was Dagnar Stonepate, apparently, and he was tremendously famous.
Famous then, dead today. He's nothing but a bone orchard now.
To meet you.
Talk to you later. A fitting reward. Look at this place. It must be tremendously old. Centuries, even.
Older than that. The dwarven civilization lasted for more than 2,000 years, and this might be one of their first structures. It's so sad that the dwarves all turned to stone and went to fight the dragons. Sad, but brave.
The dredge brought the sword here to find a way to destroy it. We'd better hurry before they succeed.
You're absolutely right. First, we have to cross that windy bridge. I can use my magic to fly, but you'll have to foot... Those flags and the torches flutter when the wind rises, so watch them carefully. Use the walls for cover. Keep your footing, go as fast as you can, and don't worry, it'll be cheery. Here we go. Watch the flags and use the walls for cover. That wind is fierce.
Out.
out. To battle again. Out. To battle again.
Whoever that Norn was, his friends took out this dredge. They took the sword, too. Nobody passed us on the way in, so they must still be in here. Maybe down this hallway. Let's go!
come forth.
Dead after all.
This place is creepy. Why are we here again?
That statue of Grenth has been leaking magic. I couldn't think of anything else that matches the power of the sanguinary blade. We'll take some shavings from the statue. If we can build a containment vessel to hold those safely, it should be able to suppress the sword. First, the fragments. Then we hurry to the Priory and work on a vessel. Ready? What? You're not scared, are you? It's just a spooky tunnel. That's collapsing. Of Grenth. Hold a moment while I collect some shavings. For an incredibly spooky hidden path with a giant statue of a god of death, this was surprisingly pleasant. There, I've got what we need. Let's head back. I borrowed some artifacts from the Priory Vault and rigged this together. It looks totally cherry. I'm sure it'll work fine.
Actually, Siren, it looks horribly dangerous. Won't someone notice those things went missing?
Oh, honestly, these have been gathering dust in the vault for years. Nobody wants them, so who'll care? I got a jadeite rune of holding, then modified it and wove the whole thing onto a shadow shard. Now, all the enchantments are merged. When the sanguinary blade is put into the shadow shard, it'll technically be off this plane of existence. The sword won't be able to corrupt anything. But, there's one problem. I need to tune the enchantments to work together instead of tearing themselves apart, or it could collapse the mountain.
Wait, what? Collapse the... Siren?
No. It'll work, I promise. While I'm doing that, though, things could get exciting, so keep your weapon out.
The things you call exciting are what most people would call reckless endangerment.
Oh, come on, novice, cheer up! The worst that could happen is that we're lost forever in shadow, but more likely we'll just have to mop up some shades. Here goes. I'll let you know when the containment unit is ready to activate.
The magical leakage seems to be coming from... Siren! Novice! What are you two doing? Give me that thing! I'll stop this. This thing is so cross-enchanted, it could power a spurious logic golem.
But the theorems all made sense.
Exactly! You can't apply sense with technology. You two, defend me while I desensify this mess.
Success. The shades are gone, and the containment field seems to be working.
I should have known the magical transfluctuation was your doing, Siren. Inexcusable. What is this patchwork drivel you've created? You put a... with a... By the alchemy! Brilliant! Insane, but absolutely ingenious! You think like an Asura, you womp-leaved lunatic, but you don't take proper precautions. If I hadn't come along when I did...
I'm sorry, Steward Gix. I thought... I mean, we needed to contain the sword, and nobody wanted this stuff.
If this wasn't such an innovative creation, I'd toss you out on your twigs. As it is, you're both on probation. No argument. Priory anarchists have scried Stieg Frostbeard's location. He's hiding in an encampment near Black Barl's mill. Get out of here. And take this mad contraption with you. If you foul this up, I'll throw you to the termites, you pernicious petal brain.
Vormir enlightened.
I need dwarven artifacts. Any you can find would be much appreciated.
Hello there, Norn. We're here from the Derman Priory, and your friend Stieg has something that belongs to us.
We're just here for Frostbeard. Bring us the sword he carries, and we won't hurt you.
Pathetic little bookworms. Stieg Frostbeard is mighty. He will attack Lion's Arch, and we will show you all dragon's power. Stieg's blood sword is a holy relic of the dragon, Jawman. The dragon blesses Stieg for his faithful service. He will lead us to victory.
It's not too late. Please, think about what you're doing. The dragon may give you power, but in exchange, he's made you slaves.
Abandoned dragon in his time of triumph? Why would we do that?
Lion's Arch is filled with innocent people. You can't do this.
They aren't listening, novice. Time to switch to Plan B. Go get them! Well done, novice. The sanguinary blade is ours, and Lion's Arch is safe from Stieg Frostbeard.
It's hard to believe that Stieg was willing to see all his Norn friends die, just to keep the power of the sanguinary blade.
That's not hard for me to believe at all, novice. It's typical of the idiots who serve Elder Dragons. The dragons are a blight. They don't care about anything but their hunger. Their followers are just bad. Even if we find a way to save the world from the dragons, I sometimes wonder if we'll ever find a way to save us from ourselves. But you know what? I really like you. You're willing to try new things, and you've got a good head on your shoulders.
Thanks, Siren. I have to admit, this has been a lot of fun.
Cherry! Come on, let's get the sword back to Gix. After that, we'll work on saving the world.
come forth.
At last, the sanguinary blade. I shudder to think of the damage it would have wrought without your aid. You've both done well. Consider yourselves off probation. I'd like you to continue your partnership with Siren. Perhaps you can keep this deciduous do-gooder out of trouble.
Thank you, Stuart Gix. I'd be happy to collaborate with Siren. We work well together.
Poor Gix. You're just jealous that you're stuck in here being leadery and responsible while we're having all the fun.
Yes, yes. I'm sure that's exactly what it is. Be that as it may, I must rely on you two for another project. Your next endeavor is a research assignment involving one of the lesser races of Tyria. Do try not to teach them bad habits, Siren.
Thank you.
practical guide to Hylek tribes says this one is friendly but insular. I suspect friendly means not hostile yet, so we'll need to win their trust.
Please, my brother served with you for many years. Help me save him.
Your brother fought for the right to be our champion. Why would you take that honor from him?
Hi there, Hylek. I'm Siren from the Derman Priory. We heard you talking to that guard. Maybe we can help.
I don't know, but I do need help. My brother was our champion. He offered himself as a sacrifice to save our village. They say it is an honor, but the champions never return, and we just keep sending more. I want to rescue my brother before it's too late.
Maybe we can help each other. If you get us in to speak with your leaders, we'll come with you to save your brother.
I can do that. I'd do anything to have my brother back. Come this way. This way. If we want to save him, we'll have to hurry. That is where they take the sacrifices. Stay close. Stay away!
Go, Father, go.
That was interesting.
My brother. No! What have they done to him?
Wait! Don't go in there alone! Everyone's always telling me, don't go in there alone!
Thank you. This thing is not my brother. My brother was a hero, a champion. The undead turned him into this. And it was the priests who sent him here. Unforgivable.
I'm sorry about your brother. But yes, each village champion becomes another undead soldier in the dragon's army. We want to stop this too.
Then we'll need to prove it. Take the head from this undead thing. And the priests and chiefs see it. They'll have to believe us.
Astonishing and gruesome, but effective. You, Hylek, know how to make a point. Look away, Ikniu, and we'll do it.
Do you see? It's like I told you. Our champions are returning as undead.
I see. You may pass. Show that to the High Priestess right away.
I'm eager to see who the next champion will be. May the Sun God smile on him. Or her.
All light, all life, all goodness comes from the Sun. Without the Sun...
We must speak to the High Priestess. We have proof that the champions are being killed and turned into undead.
I've seen your proof, but the High Priestess is not here. She's gone to prepare for the procession. She doesn't know Sabiti, and she's tired of hearing this from you. She'll say that head could be anybody's and dismiss you as a troublemaker.
We took it straight from the undead thing Sabiti had become. How else can we prove your sacrifices are actually making things worse? On second thought, never mind. Leave it to us. The Priory won't rest until we help Ikniu convince your leaders.
The tournament is nearly over, but there's still time for you to participate.
This is a sacred ceremony. Who brings these outsiders here? We need nothing from the Derman Priory. We will secure the Sun God's blessing on our own.
But isn't it true that all who live are beloved by the Sun God? Why can't a willing outsider compete?
Ikniu is right. If an outsider earns the Sun God's favor, then an outsider shall be our champion. Let the god decide.
There is hope for this challenger after all. Now, on to the chief and the next test.
Hear me, Chief Kekwan. I offer this for the challenge of words. My eyes are the keenest, my strength the greatest, my bravery the fiercest. I have slain everything that walks, swims, or crawls. I have claimed new breeding and hunting grounds for our people. I am the one.
Well said, Tachufi. You are indeed blessed. But we must hear from the newcomer. Of your chief. I declare that the outsider has won the challenge of words.
But the test is not over. The next challenge is the challenge of might. Challengers, to the testing grounds. Prepare to face the beasts of land, sea, and air. This is the final challenge. Prepare yourself. The beasts of the air will challenge all. Only a champion can defeat them.
I am not afraid. Test me, O Sun. I am ready.
Thank you.
fight for your homes and your lives.
Our troubles are over. I give up.
Listen to me. Your previous champions have all been turned into undead. They are now slaves and soldiers for the dragon's army.
Silence! The sacrifice of champions has kept us safe because the Sun God wills it so.
That's false. We've witnessed the undead army personally, and it just keeps growing larger. Soon, it will come for you. Soon, your village will be nothing but dust.
The Sun God chose these outsiders. They speak for the Sun God. We must fortify the village and defend ourselves.
No, they will not spoil the ritual. If the champion will not be our sacrifice, then I shall. I will protect the village, even if no one else will.
These creatures, and I think of my home in the grove. What would I be willing to do if something threatened it?
I miss active duty.
This way. The chief is waiting.
Hello again, chief. It looks like you've been busy. How long until your defenses are ready?
Not long. I will not let this village die because I could not see such an obvious threat.
Don't be too hard on yourself. The dragon's minions can be very sneaky. Lots of folks don't notice them creeping in until it's too late.
I'm grateful that you opened my eyes. Now I must see to the main gate. I sent my best scout to observe the enemy, and he should be back soon. It would help the villagers to see you standing with us. Would you check the rest of our defenses and make sure they're done?
Hoping to fall in love at least once before I died. But I guess I'm ready. If you are.
Listen, my people. Listen to your chief. The sunless dragon spawn deceived us. They defiled our champions and are now coming for us. But we will fight! I've sent our best scout to observe their approach. When they come, we will be ready to...
Chief Kekwan? I've failed. The undead. They're coming.
Koyolaki, can you hear me? Hang on. We can still open the gates.
Don't. It's too late. They're already here.
Run then. Hide yourself. We will come for you when the battle's won. Koyolaki, please, by the Holy Sun, answer me! The Sunless are here. Stand fast!
You're in trouble now.
blasphemy. She's one of them now.
Gone. Our homes, our hunting grounds, our breeding grounds, all gone. But it would have been worse without the Priory.
We're sorry you lost your home, but this is just a sliver of the dragon's power. Unless we all work together, this will happen to all of Tyria.
Then send for me when you need allies against the dragons, and I will come. For my brother and my village, I owe you that much.
Good. Because that fight is coming, soon, and we will need all the help we can muster. We have more work to do, but I wish you luck in settling new grounds. May the Holy Sun shine on you and protect you until we meet again.
Maybe you could show me some moves.
Thank you.
More people should learn to bark.
I need more Lux modulators. These are shot. I think I can make these work if I have to.
Are you ready for battle, good one?
I've been through worse, tall one.
I need more Lux modulators. These are shot. I think I can make these work if I have to. All of them. Now we'll have a real display of the power of Asura know-how.
Defend those mega lasers while they blast the bone ship. The leg.
Thank you.
It has life. Might makes me right. Another land to spread my legacy.
Thank you. next time.
Thank you.